Hello friends, welcome back to our channel NEET Biology Expert. I am Dr. Parveen. In this lecture series, we are studying Class 12 Biology Chapter Reproductive Health. In this particular lesson, we are going to study about medical termination of pregnancy. That's called MTP. What is medical termination of pregnancy, MTP? What is the definition for this? It is an intentional or voluntary termination of pregnancy before full term. That is called medical termination of pregnancy. What happens here? Here, abortion is carried out. Okay, the baby is developing in the mother's womb, in the uterus. So before completion of the 9 months, that is the full term, the baby is aborted. That is called abortion, and that is also called as medical termination of pregnancy. Why? Because this abortion is done intentionally. Intentionally means for a cause. The cause must be a noble cause. Okay, it is done intentionally and also voluntarily. So nobody is compelling, and the woman takes the decision. She accepts for that abortion. Okay, so it is an intentional and voluntary termination of the pregnancy before the full term. So that is called MTP. This MTP is also called as induced abortion or induced miscarriage. So here, this abortion is not happening automatically or naturally. Somebody is inducing that. Okay, so that's why it is called as induced abortion or also called as induced miscarriage. So here, there is another thing called spontaneous abortion. Spontaneous abortion means the abortion that occurs without anybody's intervention. So nobody is doing that intentionally. It is happening because of some medical reasons or because of some conditions in the body of the mother, some reasons. Okay, so it is happening naturally. So that is called as spontaneous abortion. So we are classifying this abortion into two broad categories. Okay, so the first one is called spontaneous abortion. So this spontaneous abortion occurs approximately 30% to 50% of the pregnancies spontaneously. Okay, so in 30 to 50% almost we can say 1/3 of the pregnancies will have spontaneous abortion, and this will occur within 4 weeks of conception, not later. That generally it happens within the first 4 weeks. Okay, because when the embryo is developing, it takes time to fix, and it mingles with the mother's tissue. Okay, because that time only placenta, umbilical cord, everything goes. Okay, so that's why when a woman is pregnant, elders used to say should not travel long distance, should not climb stairs, should not run like this, because there is a risk for getting abortion, spontaneous abortion, in the first 4 weeks of pregnancy time. Okay, so why this abortion occurs? That may be because of various reasons. Could be due to some immunological abnormalities, maybe in mother health also. A major trauma, any accident, any shock may affect the mother, so that may lead to abortion. Or any uterine abnormalities present in the mother, could be a fibroid, adhesion, anything. So here we say most often the cause for the spontaneous abortion is unknown. We don't know exactly what is the reason why this abortion happened. Okay, so this natural spontaneous abortion. On the other hand, we have something called therapeutic abortion or induced abortion. So here what happens? Here somebody is intentionally, legally terminating the pregnancy. Okay, so legally terminating pregnancy, it is done intentionally. And here, in order to execute this induced abortion, the doctor's advice is needed. What advice? Suppose if the mother who is pregnant has a serious health issue, if the growing embryo may affect her health. Okay, otherwise if the embryo or the fetus has some malformities, okay, not grown well, some chromosomal abnormalities, if any such things are there, the doctor advised the mother not to carry out the pregnancy full term. Okay, in such conditions, they will execute this induced abortion. So these are the differences between spontaneous abortion and induced or therapeutic abortion. So here, if we see the incidence of the MTPs, nearly 45 to 50 million MTPs are performed in a year all over the world. So which accounts for nearly 1/5 of the total number of the conceived pregnancy. Yeah. So if 5 women is getting pregnant, means 1 out of the 5 she is doing MTP. Okay. So this MTP, if we take the overall statistics, around 45 to 50 million MTPs are performed in a year all over the world. So look at this video. This is how this abortion is carried out. So here the fetus is there growing in the mother's womb happily. So what the doctor will do, the doctor will insert a vacuum pump. So the vacuum pump is inserted in her uterus and they suck out all the small organs, tissues of the baby. Individually the hand will be sucked out, the legs will be sucked out, the body will be sucked out like this. This is a very cruel process. Okay, later if any tissues are remaining, they will scoop the rest of the tissues from the uterus. Okay, so this will lead to many risk factors, like there will be injury to the uterus in the cervix, there will be hemorrhage in the mother, it may lead to infection, sometimes it may cause death to the mother also. Okay, so such complications are there in this abortion procedure. Now we must understand why these MTPs are carried out. Okay, there are various reasons for this. The first one is to get rid of unwanted pregnancies. Suppose a couple, they don't want to have babies, okay, and they are following some birth control measures. What happens? Sometimes the birth control measures, they won't work. It fails. The contraceptive methods fail. For example, we know this intrauterine device, copper T. The copper T has expiry date. 5 years copper T is there, 10 years copper T is there, okay. So till 5 years, the copper molecules will be released out and it works well in her uterus. So after 5 years, what happened? The concentration of the copper molecules will be reduced. Okay. So after 5 years, the woman should compulsorily remove her intrauterine device and again she has to insert a new device. If not done, what will happen? The expired intrauterine device will not work and it will fail. So in such situation, she will become pregnant. Okay, that is called as unwanted pregnancy because of the failure of the contraceptive used during the coitus. Okay, and sometimes casual unprotected intercourse. So many young people, they do sexual intercourse without any contraceptive methods used. So accidentally they may get pregnant. Okay, so during such situation they want to do the MTP. And very important, in India, the major reason for the MTPs, one of the major reasons is rapes. So the rapes, the woman or the victim, whoever is there, she don't want to get pregnant, she don't want to carry the baby, right? So legally the baby will be aborted. So this is the few reasons for the MTPs. Okay? And also essential in certain cases where continuation of the pregnancy could be harmful to both the mother or fetus. Suppose if a happy couple, they want to have baby, okay, so they are planning for a baby and the woman gets pregnant, and when she goes for the monthly checkup, during the scanning the doctor finds out that the baby has some issues, the baby not grown well, the baby is hydrocephalus. Hydrocephalus means bulging of the head, brain is not formed, some deformities, the extremities are not well formed. So in such condition, the doctors advise the couples not to continue this pregnancy. Okay, because even if the baby is born, it will not survive. Okay, sometimes what will happen, ectopic pregnancy, you know ectopic pregnancy, right? Ectopic pregnancy means the fertilization occurs and the baby and the blastocyst get implanted in the fallopian tube. So in such cases, the embryo starts to grow in the fallopian tube. So during scanning, if the doctor finds out that ectopic pregnancy is there, it is not safe for the mother. Okay, so in such condition, the doctor advises the mother to do the MTP. So like that, some medical reasons are there for this MTP. Okay? And defective development of the fetus examined during the amniocentesis. We know amniocentesis is a medical procedure where the amniotic fluid will be taken out. It contains the baby cells, growing embryo cells. Karyotyping will be done using this amniocentesis. So we could able to know if the growing fetus is having any chromosomal abnormalities, okay, Down syndrome or any other chromosomal abnormality. If such conditions are there, then the doctor advised the couple not to continue the pregnancy. It is better to do the abortion. Okay. So like this, these are the few reasons for the MT. Okay. But the most dangerous trend is the misuse of the amniocentesis, determine the sex of the unborn child. So now what happens? People are doing scanning, people are doing amniocentesis. That time they see that if it is a female baby, they don't want to have female child. So that time they ask the doctor to please do abortion for me because we don't want a female baby like that. So doing amniocentesis or doing a scanning, finding the sex of the baby and then doing this MT, this is totally illegal. It's totally illegal. So this is called as illegal abortion. There is no noble cause. Just they are saying that the growing embryo is a female baby. They don't want female baby, so they want to abort it. So this is called as a female feticide. Feticide means killing the fetus. Female feticide. So this is a highly illegal procedure. So because of these things, many countries, they have a debate like whether to accept or to legalize the MTP or not. This is being debated upon in many countries because doing such abortion is related to emotional, ethical, religious and social issues. Okay, so some group of people, they say that this is my body, my choice. I don't want this baby. This is my baby. I am aborting. What's your problem like that? Some women, they say. Okay. But this religious people say that abortion is murder. Okay. So you're killing a life. So abortion is murder like that. So there arised a debate in many countries because of this emotional, ethical, religious and social issues regarding the MTP. So let us see what is the status of India regarding this MTP. The government of India has legalized this MTP in 1971 with some strict conditions to avoid its misuse. Okay, so Indian government has told that, okay, people, if you want to do abortion, you could execute abortion, but there must be a noble cause. Okay, that is what this act is telling. So this is called as MTP Act, which came in 1971. Okay, so what is the main important thing for this act? That is to check the indiscriminate and illegal female feticides. So in India, previously, you see, in 1960s, 1950s and all, if they found that the growing embryo is a female, they used to abort it because they don't want the female baby. So in order to reduce such female feticides, mainly this act was passed. Okay, right? So what is this is telling? The Medical Termination of Pregnancy Amendment Act 2017 under Section 3 of the MTP Act 1971 was enacted by the Government of India. Okay. So what is the intention of this act? The intention of this act is to reduce the incidence of the illegal abortion. This is important. Illegally, nobody should abort any child. Okay. Because this may result in maternal mortality and morbidity. The most important thing is not only the fetus, mother has high mortality rate. Okay, so the woman is having high mortality rate and she has more morbidity. Morbidity means many side effects, and second time she could not able to conceive, like this many problems arises, right? So to avoid all such things, this MTP Act 2017 was enacted. So according to this act, pregnancy may be terminated on certain considered grounds. Okay. So if somebody wants to do MTP, first, it should be within the first 12 weeks of pregnancy. That means in the earlier stage. Okay. First 12 weeks of pregnancy, but an opinion of one registered medical practitioner is compulsory. So a doctor's certificate should be there. The doctor should certify that, okay, this woman can do abortion because if not aborted, the growing embryo may harm the mother. There is a danger for the mother's health. Like this, okay? The practitioner should give opinion. So first, if it is done first within 12 weeks, opinion of one practitioner, medical practitioner is needed. If the pregnancy is lasted for more than 12 weeks but less than 24 weeks, that means 12 to 24 weeks if the pregnancy period is there, in that time, if they want to abort, this is a highly risky situation. But then also, two registered medical practitioners must be given the opinion, right? So if it is less than 12 weeks, certificate of one medical practitioner is needed. If it is more than 24 weeks, more than 12 weeks and less than 24 weeks, the opinion and certificate of two medical practitioners are needed, okay? Right. So what should be there in that practitioner opinion, the doctor's opinion? The registered medical practitioner's opinion is mandatory, stating that continuation of the pregnancy would involve a risk to the life of the pregnant woman. So this is important. So if this pregnancy is continued, it is highly risky for the mother's health. Okay, so in such case, it is allowed legally. And there is a substantial risk that if the child were born, it would suffer from physical mental abnormalities as to be seriously handicapped. So if the child has any chromosomal abnormalities or hydrocephalus, malformed face, limbs, extremities like this, so even if that child is born, okay, it is not good. The child will be seriously handicapped. It won't survive for a long period of time. So in such condition, it is better to abort the fetus. So like this, the reason should be clearly mentioned by the doctor. So this is the legally speaking MTP Act in India. So these are the various reasons. First, the woman's physical or mental health are endangered by the pregnancy. So in order to do the abortion, one of these reasons should be satisfied. Then only it will be legally approved. So if the mother's health is in danger, then it is allowed. Okay. Or the woman is facing the birth of a potentially disabled or malformed child. So if the growing embryo is a disabled embryo or a malformed child, in that case, it is better to abort it in the growing stage. Or if the woman is a rape victim, this is most important case of India. If she is a rape victim, that time it is legally approved to abort. If the girl is a minor, less than 18 years, okay? So, by any reason, if she get conceived or by rape or something, if she get conceived, so that time, if she is a minor and unmarried and with the proper consent from a guardian, this MTP is, could be done. Or if the woman is a lunatic means mentally not stable, okay? So, like that condition, so somebody might have raped her, so such conditions will be there. So, this is approved. Or pregnancies that are a result of failure in the sterilization. So we know that one of the birth control method, permanent birth control method, is tubectomy, right? So tubectomy is carried out for the women. Mostly tubectomy is the commonest birth control method in India. So after a woman has undergone tubectomy in a hospital, the doctor will give certificate. She is now permanently sterile like that, okay? So after tubectomy, she could do her sexual intercourse. Suppose if that sterilization was a failure, she may get pregnant. Okay. So in such case, there is no mistake in the woman, right? So that was a failure surgery. So in that case, if she don't want that baby, aborting that baby is legally approved, right? Finally, compulsory, the duration of the pregnancy must be less than 20 weeks. That means from 12 to 20 weeks. So if any of these reasons are satisfied, fulfilled, then it is legal to carry out this MTP. Okay. So let us learn when to do MTP. So it is highly safe during the first trimester of pregnancy. Because when the fetus is in the growing stage, that time it is very easy and safe for the MTP to carry out. That means up to 12 weeks of pregnancy. And that time also, there is no impact on the woman's fertility. That means again, for the next time, if the woman wants to conceive, this will not affect, the first abortion will not affect her fertility. okay, if it is done in the first trimester. But if the MTP is done in the second trimester, so such second trimester abortions are more riskier because the fetus becomes intimately associated with the maternal tissue. We know the right a grown up fetus has a good connection with the maternal tissue, and both the maternal tissue and the fetal, this chorionic villi, they together form the placenta. The exchange will be there. So like this, so during such time, if the fetus is grown well, so during such time if abortion is done, it is highly risky for the mother. It may even result in the death of the mother. Okay, so that's why doing abortion in the second trimester of pregnancy is not recommended at all. But in India, one disturbing trend, one worrisome fact is that majority of the abortions are carried out illegally. Illegally means not as per the laws. Okay, who is doing this? Unqualified quacks. Quacks means frauds, we can say frauds. Okay, so some people, they do this abortion, they are not a qualified doctor, they are not MBBS doctor, not a registered practitioner, they don't know how to do this procedure safely. Okay, so doing such thing is highly unsafe and it could be fatal. Fatal for whom? Fatal for the mother. So that is the most important thing happening in India. Okay, so such practices should be avoided because these are dangerous for both the young mother and the fetus. Sometimes they won't do the abortion properly, so the fetus some abnormality they may create because they just like scoop the fetus in the uterus. Okay, so it will disturb the fetal body, fetal limbs, something like that will happen. Okay, or most of the time the mother's life will be under threat. So these are the problems happening in India till now, okay, because of this illegally carried out abortion. So let us see how to reduce or how to avoid this MTPs. So we know that though we have a strict act regarding MTP in India, but people are doing this illegally. So how to reduce this? So first of all, if a woman is undergone abortion, means if it is a first conception, it has a very serious psychological consequences for her. It creates some psychological problem for her because that is her first baby. Okay, so how to avoid such conditions? We have to give effective counseling. Counseling regarding what? The need to avoid unprotected coitus. So we have to counsel, we have to give education, sex education to the young persons. Like if you don't want to have babies, you have to follow the birth control procedures. This will avoid unnecessary pregnancy. So if unnecessary pregnancy is avoided, then this MTP will be reduced, right? So counseling should be given. So here if we see, approximately half of the unintended pregnancies are due to contraceptive failures. So many people, many young people, they don't know how to use this birth control methods. So as I told previously, if copper T has an expiry date, after the expiry date, she has to go to the hospital, remove it, and again she has to insert another fresh IUD. If she keeps on wearing that IUD, it won't have the sufficient copper molecules, so it may lead to failure, right? So like that, contraceptive failures is the major reason for this MTPs. And second one, many people, they don't know how to use the contraceptive procedures correctly also. Okay, so we have to educate young women about the usage of the intrauterine devices, contraceptive implants. So if such things, such education is given to the young women, this will drastically reduce the percentage of unnecessary MTPs. Mostly it will be illegal MTPs only. Okay, so that level or rate will be reduced. So I hope you understand this lecture. Our next lecture will be on sexually transmitted disease. So if you like this, like, share and subscribe to our channel, Neat Biology Expert. Thank you.